Well, maybe I shouldn't say that. I don't know. Hey guys, it's Suresh. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for joining me for another fun doll review today. This is actually my very first video of 2017. My Boucle Beauty video I actually shot in December. I thought the best way to start 2017 was with one of my absolute favorite dolls in my collection that I have yet to unbox. She is the 10-year celebration for the Barbie Fashion Model Collection. I've actually done an inbox review of Miss Tribute Barbie. It was one of the first videos I did here on my channel. And now that I look back at it, I'm like, yeah. I filmed that almost a year ago to the day. Today, we're gonna take her out of the box. This is such a gorgeous doll. My parents were recently in town and I showed this to them and they were just so cute. They were just like, oh wow, what a beautiful doll, honey. We can't wait for you to unbox it. So one other thing I wanted to mention to you guys before we start our video, you all know my collection quite well, I feel like, for the most part. I do have some new additions behind me actually that I got from Christmas. My sister gave me her Indian Barbie doll that she's had forever. I also got a Batman doll to complete my Wonder Woman Superman collection. So if you guys want to see a review on that, do comment down below and let me know. I'm going to start auctioning off some of my dolls that you see here in my cabinet. Why? I don't know. Maybe I'm a little bit crazy. I really need to be a little more edited. I need to get rid of some dolls in order to bring some new dolls in. I'm super short on space, and as you guys know, I talk about editing all the time. It's very difficult to do for us doll collectors and doll addicts. However, I will put a link down below to my eBay shop, and you guys will have to check there from time to time because I will be listing some of these pre-owned beauties, and you guys know that I take very good care of my dolls. So yeah, without further ado, I think we should get started with today's review. January 2010 was the launch date of Miss Beautiful Tribute Barbie. She comes in this stunning big box. There were 10,000 of her made worldwide. She is just such a beautiful doll, and I absolutely love the presentation of this doll. As you guys know, I have unribboned her before. However, I have never taken her out, and oh my God, yes, girl. Oh, oh my God, she's so gorgeous. Oh my God, these earrings, the makeup, the hair, the embroidery. Oh, and the shoes, you know I love the shoes. Inside the box, we have her certificate of authenticity, and oh, that's interesting. It's actually not in plastic, it's in a little wax paper envelope. So that's cute. 10 years tribute Barbie doll, there it is right there. There are also care instructions in here for her. Wow, there we go, you guys. So she has a pink background in the box, and then the back is standard silkstone packaging. She's tied down with like cream colored ribbons. Here we go, here we go. Yes, girl, how you doing, mama? Oh my God, you guys, she's so heavy and perfect. She does come with the standard silkstone base. It is a white base. She does have the saddle stand. She has some padding on the back, which I believe is protecting her from hitting the box. These shoes though, oh my God. Only Barbie can pull off monochromatic shoes and outfit in a color like this and make you look so chic. Do you know what I mean? Wow, look at the back here. Okay, so there is definitely some box dress going on here. This I will need to very gently steam. She does come with a hairnet, and her earrings also have a little guard on them. These earrings, you guys, they're like human size. Look at that. I'm going to take this hairnet off. Whew. Let's all just say a prayer here. This hair, oh my God, oh my God. She has gorgeous eye makeup on, some gold glitter on her eyelids, blue eyes, blonde hair, lots of different colors of blonde. Her hair is very hairsprayed. Why can I not speak today? What the actual hell? Absolutely beautiful hairdo. It has some beautiful curl action here on the side. She does have a lock of hair that is drawn over her hairline in the front, and it's stitched in place with a little stitch there, very similar to Fashionably Floral. The hairstyle also reminds me of who? Ooh, wow, it's very, very similar to the 2016 glam gown doll's hair. These earrings are so beautiful. This crystal they used right here in the beginning break point is just so gorgeous. This color, this very beautiful sort of woad blue, it's just so, so magnificent with the beautiful original silkstone body. Oh my gosh. Skin tone is definitely very pale. Alabaster, I would say. She has a very, very light frosted pink lip and a very light faint blush. She has a beauty mark under her left eye. Now, you know I'm dying to see what color her manicure is, so let's take a quick look, shall we? And moment of truth. Oh my god, look at her little hand. Beautiful light pink manicure that matches her lip color perfectly. She also has stockings on. I mean, she is just dressed for an occasion. There's such a Charles James element to her gown that I love so much. The buoyancy of the fabric with just the excessiveness of it all. The tiered ruffles is so, so beautiful. All right, so speaking of these ruffles, let's talk about them for a second. At the very top, we have a tulle, a very beautiful light tulle that is edged with this organza, which is gorgeous. And the craftsmanship on this is just really exquisite, I will say. Underneath that, we have a layer of organza. Now, this is the same organza that this tulle is edged with, so that's exquisite. Stitching on this is beautiful. All the thread is in the same beautiful soft woad blue. Underneath that, we have the lining, which appears to be like a polyester taffeta. Has a nice stiffness to it, has a nice crinkle to it that you can hear. I love that papery sounding fabric, especially for a gown like this because it gives it so much structure. It's really the tulle and the organza that is creating all this volume here. I know that in real life, a gown like this could be a bit hard to pull off, but I tell you what, on Barbie, it is just exquisite. Beautiful sweetheart neckline with a wraparound bustier. But the silhouette of it is just so nicely complementing each other because the top is a little more bare, the bottom is exquisitely full. If it was full up here too, it would look a little more like, I guess the 90s Barbies, you know, that just had so much up here, so much of the waist, so much of the knees, so much of the ankles, and it was just like, okay, girl, it's a bit much. This, I find very contemporary, although it is definitely an ode to old world haute couture. Look at the silhouette of that on the side. Isn't that just stunning? Just so beautiful, you guys, and I just, oh, I'm just gaga for this doll. She's so beautiful. I have to say, there's something chic about her without the gloves on, don't you think? I mean, I feel like, I guess it's just more realistic because in real life, a woman who would wear a gown like this probably would not wear the gloves with it. However, this is not real life, this is Barbie, and she can do whatever the hell she won't do, okay? And we still gonna be like, ooh girl, you look fierce. Let's talk about this gorgeous embellishment. Almost up close has a very like Chinese dragon sort of look to it, but then you pull away from it and it looks much more like old world French, shall we say, from like Versailles or something like that. What I also love is that her gown is not supported with any sort of clear straps, which would have killed it. However, I do see some double-sided tape here on her bust, which leads me to believe that the dress is in fact double-sided taped onto her. So you guys know that it would not be a real Suresh review if I did not take off this gown and take a look inside. I say this in every single one of my videos, but she definitely was not designed to be taken out of the box because there is nothing on her back, which is a bummer because I wish that they would have carried a little bit of the embroidery to the back. Now, a little bit of the bustier did make it to the back, which is nice. A little bit of something back here would have been beautiful because in real life, an haute couture gown would never have this on the front and nothing on the back. I am undoing these snaps back here. Two large silver snaps right there. I am definitely feeling that she is double-sided taped into the dress. This gown is exquisite. So I'm looking at the inside of it. It is not lined on the inside, and I understand why, because that would add more bulk to it. I would have hoped to have seen a more lined garment, considering that this is a 10-year celebration doll and all that. However, It's fine. It's beautiful. Looking down here on the inside, and the one thing I will say is where the ruffles meet the gown is not especially neat. I think this is definitely preventable, but what we're seeing here is this little bit of fuzz from the organza. Organza is very, very difficult to keep from unraveling. And even though polyester organza, which is what this is a little bit better about that, there is still some fraying here that we can see. So it would have been nice if they finished this off. However, I understand that these types of details are asking a lot of a somewhat mass-produced doll. The seaming on the tulle is not the best. It is what it is, I guess. Same thing here on the organza lining, and then the dress lining here itself Are you dying over this? I'm dying. And let me give you a close-up at this absolutely exquisite embroidery. I mean, it's so beautiful. Do you see it? Do you see it? Do you see it? You see it, right? You can see all the different colors that are in the paillettes here. There are rose, there are lavender, iridescent pink, there's silver up here on the bodice area. So I love that so much. And then here is the back. And then let me also show you the inside of the garment. This is what I said about it not being fully finished. However, you can see and appreciate the craftsmanship and the work that has gone into it. Obviously, you guys know that I would have loved for them to do a little bit more of a finishing job on this, but it is what it is, y'all. It is what it is. And here are the two snaps, big silver snaps, because this is quite the tight dress on her. Down here in the back definitely has box dress, as we already talked about. And here are all these beautiful ruffles up close in your face, just like so. Woo-woo. Here is our gorgeous doll in the buff. As you can see, I have started to very gently lift off that double-sided tape off of her right breast there. But there are two pieces of tape, one on the side of the bust, one on the top to keep the dress in place. That will be coming off because I don't think we need that. Just take a look at her exquisite eye makeup. I mean, do you see the little bit of glitter in there? Do you see that crystal in her earring that is so multifaceted that it kind of shimmers and glows so much? I love that so much. Check out the rose beads in her earring as well. I just think this is so exquisite. Let me see if I can get you a very close, up close and personal view. Yes, girl. There is her dew from the side. There is her beautiful little glove on her right hand with her Barbie fashion model tag. Here is her gorgeous little shoe. Looks like a D'Orsay, although it's not. And there she is with one of her shoes on. There is her beautiful little right hand and her little manicure that I love so much. So there we have it. This is the gorgeous, absolutely stunning tribute Barbie doll from 2010. She was the Barbie fashion model 10-year anniversary celebratory doll. I hope you guys enjoyed the review and I hope that you learned something. If you liked the video, please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Check me out on Instagram. I am at SureshNY and that's generally where I post all my updates. And until I see you guys again, Barbie and I are gonna go to the Waldorf Astoria Hotel this evening. We have an invitation to a bougie-ass gala tonight. Wherever you guys are in the world, I hope you're having a fantastic day. Big hugs and kisses from me and Barbie here in New York. Mwah. I will see you guys again very soon, okay? Bye.